The Google Stadia keynote launched just a couple of days ago, and it had a ton of information about the future of the platform. Now, this didn't cover upcoming games, but what it did cover was the plans it had for the game developers going forward. This was presented in multiple presentations, but I will sum up the important parts in just a couple of minutes. Now, before I do, hit that subscribe button so you can keep on top of cloud gaming news that you need to hear. Karine Yap is part of the strategic business development team, and she's first up with the new development incentive announcements.
Starting this month, any new title that enters into Stadia Pro under the new Stadia Pro terms will earn a slice of monthly revenue from the service. Stadia Pro will give back 70% of monthly revenue to partners based upon engagement for active, claimable Stadia Pro titles. We're also unveiling a new way to power player engagement through our affiliate marketing program. Starting in Q4 this calendar year, we're launching a limited-time incentive program that adjusts our revenue share for newly signed games to an 85-15 split for game sales up to a $3 million threshold. This will apply to all games launching in Q4 of this year and in 2022 and in 2023. That means you, as a Stadia partner, will earn 85% of your title sales and Google will earn 15%.
So Google is now offering a very competitive rate for developers to develop their game on Stadia. They'll be getting paid by the game, and with this new 85-15 split in revenue sharing for upcoming titles, the incentives to develop on Stadia are huge. Not only that, but the affiliate marketing plan will also help make money for developers. This way, they can market their game on Stadia and convert users over to Stadia Pro. Hopefully, the affiliate program will also extend to YouTubers and other affiliate marketers as well. Next up, we have the Stadia technical session that deals with the new developer tools to help make creating and porting over games much easier. Elizabeth, Ryan, and Robert go over in details the fundamentals of how they are going to help developers work with Stadia. I won't bore you with the details, but all you really need to know is this. These new tools will help developers view and test their game on various platforms and ease certificate requirements. They've also made it easy to integrate games developed from popular game engines, Unity and Unreal. They also made a toolkit for integrating custom game engines into Stadia. All of this can and should open the game developer floodgates, so Stadia as a platform will be a top option for developers to come and publish their game. Now, last and certainly not least, are the new partners for Stadia. Now, for me, this might be the most important aspect of the keynote. Product manager Alan Joyce reveals the new partners they have that will support Stadia on their products so that everyone who purchases products with these specific brands will have easy access to Stadia.
There's more on the way later this year and next, such as a partnership we recently announced to bring Stadia to LG smart TVs. Stadia Pro is a big focus for us on the Stadia team this year as well. We're investing in third-party partnerships with folks like OnePlus, Lenovo, AT&T, Asus, and others. As an example, in June, we launched a program with AT&T where millions of their fiber and 5G subscribers were offered 6 free months of Stadia Pro to play on their devices. We're also continuing to work closely with our internal partners. We worked with YouTube last year to offer Stadia Pro to YouTube Premium subscribers, and we'll be continuing that partnership later this year. This is in addition to making extended Stadia Pro trials available to all Chromebook users as well as all Google One subscribers.
So, what does this all mean in a nutshell? Easy means of game development means more games that will be published to Stadia. This will also mean they get paid more for doing so. One of the reasons you don't see many AAA games on Stadia is because it takes too much time to port over the development resources to Stadia and get it tested and running properly. It's just been too much of a hassle. The return on investment hasn't been worth it. These new development tools should make this much easier. Also, the new Stadia partners will make it easy so everyone with a device will be able to play games on Stadia from anywhere. Imagine the Stadia app on smart TVs, and all you have to do is sync your controller, any controller, to your TV to play HD to ultra HD quality AAA games instantly. And all you have to do is sign in with your Google account. From your home, a friend's home, a hotel. And you don't have to bring squat with you, maybe just a controller. Imagine Stadia getting more free-to-play games from this. Turn on your TV or device, hit the Stadia app, and now you're playing Destiny 2, Apex Legends, or maybe even Warzone competitively for free, instantly. We are now entering the new age of gaming. This is cloud gaming. Let me know what you think in the comments below and make sure you like and subscribe because as you can see, we're just getting started at the only place where you can do battle in gaming heaven, Cloud Gaming Battle.